Street racing has become more and more popular since the arrival of the muscle cars. They were big, heavy, polluting, gas-sucking monsters that put out some incredible horsepower. This 1970 Chevrolet Chevelle LS5 is considered by many to be the epitome of the muscle car. It came from the factory with lots of chrome and about 500 horsepower. Ever since the gas crisis in the 1970s, fuel prices have continuously risen while the EPA has imposed higher emission standards. This has all led to a demand for more practical and economical cars and has ended the rule of the muscle car. Then, in 1982, German automaker Volkswagen launched the original pocket rocket, the Rabbit GTI. It was affordable, practical, and it outperformed most of the cars on the road. Other automakers, such as Honda and Nissan, soon followed with their own versions of small sports cars. This was the beginning of a whole new generation of street racers.
We have set meeting spots that everyone knows about, you know, Camaros, Civics, Mustangs, every kind of car usually shows up.
We'll meet at the gas station or the parking lot, and then we'll go to the race spot, and if the cops are there, then we just take off and come back later. Why do you guys come to the street races?
Just come hang out, do whatever, check out the fun.
Well, I come mainly just to kick it, you know, see a lot of my friends, bet on some races, make some money.
There's nothing else to do.
Meet some girls.
It's an adrenaline rush. Just all adrenaline, pure adrenaline.
Just for the fun?
Just for the fun of it, man, competition.
See who's got the best car out here.
We'll be right back.
had the motors on the south end of San Fernando Road, and we had the black and white units on the north. We let them set up and do a little racing here, and went ahead and shut them in, called the units in to close them in, and it worked out great.
Sorry. There you go.
That's cold.
There's your license.
That is neat.
What are you guys coming out here for?
Because I live out here. Yeah, he lives. Okay. Just
don't you know we're out here?
Nope.
Did anybody tell you guys that we've been out here for the last couple of weekends?
No.
Okay. Well, this is the bottom line here, okay? We're trying to clean this mess up. You're getting off easy tonight. Next time you're out here, you might not get out so easy, all right? So don't come back out here again.
Yep.
It's a long walk back to Beverly Hills.
I mean, with the cops, you know, a lot of them are, I don't know, I guess they're kind of just doing their job, but I mean, if they're really doing their job, they would have better things to do than to chase around and pull over like cars, you know? Mm-hmm. And I think for them, I think, you know, it's an easy thing for them, you know, because, I mean, they're going to pull over a car, they're going to, you know, give tickets, and the city's going to make money. You know, most likely, there's no one that's going to shoot at you or anything, you know, it's pretty easy and pretty safe.
I don't know. You'll find, like, one that's, like, he's a cool guy, you know, cool cop or whatever, not just going to pull you over. So I think someone in a fix-up car that's, you know, spending their time fixing up their cars, you know, it's better than them going out gangbanging, you know, whatever, you know what I mean?
Basically, I mean, a cop is doing what he has to do, you know, you pay the cop to enforce the law, and that's what he does, that's his job. It's not his fault that he has to go bust, you know, the illegal street races. He does what he has to do.
Did you start this club, or were you just chosen as president?
Actually, I did start it with a friend. It was just popular to start your own crew and to try to get ready and whatnot.
The car, my parents bought me the car, but as far as all my performance parts, I either had a loan or I worked real hard for my money. I've been working a full-time job for the past 2-3 years now trying to just get money for my car.
So how much are you spending in the car?
At least $6,000 or $7,000. At least. I don't know. After that, I
stopped
keeping track.
What I want to become is I want to become a cop, but I'm probably going to have a cop with a totally illegal car, but hey.
Do you think there needs to be a racetrack around here? Do you think it would cut down a lot of street racing?
I think it would cut down a little, but not totally.
Having a place like Terminal Island would, I believe, myself, would cut down the illegal street racing, because when it was open, majority of the people were going out to Terminal Island to race. The street races were cut down a bit, but now, since Terminal Island is gone, street racing is all over again. Terry or somewhere, everybody's going out doing something that they want to do. If they had someplace open, they wouldn't be going to the street races. They'd be going to the illegal track.
Terminal Island was open. It was great. It was fantastic. Yeah, it was fantastic.
I didn't like their lights. Yeah, their lights at the time were.
Yeah, but what was nice about the place? It was open till midnight. It was every weekend.
It was fun. It was a great time.
It was great. I loved it there. I've been street racing since 1976. I went to Somar High. We used to ditch at nutrition. Back in 1976, we had 30, 40 race cars in the school at Somar High. We used to go over to San Fernando Road and see who had the fastest cars. And I've seen thousands of street races in San Fernando Road, and I've seen about 7 crashes. You're an auto enthusiast to start with. You got all these speed shops around that sell us this equipment. Americans love speed. We all love to go fast. If you're a hobbyist like I am, you know, I like to build it and I like to test it and run it. You know, there's not enough drag strips around to do this.
Woo! 5 to 10 years ago, when I was doing a little bit of street racing, it's a lot more difficult to go to a legal event. By that, what I mean is the places you could go were very distant. Typically, you'd have to drive 100 miles, and they would only allow imports on certain days. So it almost made more sense back then to be able to do that. But now, there's a lot of places that are allowing more imports. There's a lot of actual sponsored events for the imports only.
The Battle of the Imports was the first venue for the import quarter-mile drag racing. It started about 7 years ago, and about 50 fans in the grandstands, and only about 10, 20 cars racing. Now it's grown to over 15,000. Spectators in attendance and over 800 cars racing in a weekend.
design. I got a 94 Nissan Sentra. I got a header, filter, crane high six ignition, Nology wires, and plastic gloss. I'm running mid to low 15s right now.
This is a 63 Volkswagen that's a drag race car. It's got a 2010 motor, dual 48 RPM Webers. Strictly for drag racing, it goes, should go low 12s.
Like I said, it's my second time coming out to the track. First time I battled, and the first time I went to Bakersfield. It's a lot safer than the street races. And plus, you know, you get the time slips on your car, and you can, you know, see if you're, like, improving and stuff. Because at the street races, you know, you got to worry about the cops, and then, you know, people crashing and stuff, you know, get tickets. It's a lot safer at the track.
Street races have always been popular since the 50s, and I don't think they're going to go away. I mean, I think it's going to be around forever. Because it's just, you know, everyone's love for speed and stuff. They just, you know, like, it's competition, it's like human nature.